Meanwhile, here we are in Calais, where I suppose this must be the most familiar landmark. Rodin's statue of six burghers who in 1347 offered themselves as hostages when the besieged town surrendered to Edward III.
Calais was a British possession for more than 200 years. But the rate at which the British are returning and the amount of money they're spending here must have aroused some suspicions that we're trying to buy it back. A million of us came here last year and spent on average £10 a head. Most were on day trips, but Calais is also available all year round for a short break holiday.
In England, this free tourist board booklet called Let's Go is the Bible for winter weekenders. It has details of more than 1,000 hotels which cut their rates at this time of year.
I've started to fill up this trolley with some of the most popular buys by the British. There are things typically French, of course, which I always take home. That's a stick of bread, garlic and cheese. And there are some very good bargains. These glasses, for instance, which are crystal, work out at less than £1. And the kitchenware, the Le Creuset pans, excellent value. This one is £15. Perhaps one of the best buys of all, beer. There are 10 bottles in here, and they work out at 12 pence each only. The coffee, these are beans, less than half price, and you can't go home from France without wine. Here we've got red, rosé and white, and all those bottles are in fact around £1 only each. And a staggering statistic, in this hypermarket, in 1 month, the British alone bought 10,000 gallons of wine.
The allowance, by the way, on wine is 7 litres per adult, as long as you buy it in a supermarket like this or in town and not in a duty-free shop, and you don't take back any spirits. And that's it for this week.
Next week we shall be at the International Boat Show in London. Do join us then. Bye.
Bye.